welcome to another episode of Cooking Matters live on Facebook. Today's recipe is blackened tilapia fish tacos with a pineapple cucumber slaw. Yummy. Let me wash my hands so we can get started. Grab some soap and water. I'll let you know all the ingredients that we need because we are doing several steps. All right, for the ingredients, we are going to need our tilapia right here, 1.5 pounds of tilapia fillets, our corn tortillas for our tacos. I am not gonna use cheese. I don't like cheese in my fish tacos. For the marinade, we're gonna use olive oil, lime juice. I am not gonna use soy sauce. And the spice rub, I already have it here, ready to go. And what I added here is chile ancho powder, brown sugar, smoked paprika, ground cumin, garlic powder, onion powder, salt, oregano, pepper, and no cayenne pepper because I don't like it spicy. And this is what's gonna make our tilapia blackened once we cook it. So let me go ahead and put some oil on the bottom. And then again, you can use any of your favorite oil. I am using avocado oil and I am using my hands to pat it down. And then my fish was previously dry as well. Let me go ahead and add several fillets. It's just a faster process to have several fillets at a time. Then these two can stay here. And I'm just gonna drizzle our oil, grapeseed oil, avocado oil, olive oil, favorite oil. And the same thing, we're just gonna rub it with our hands. And this is gonna make our rub stick. And if you don't like touching raw fish, go ahead and use some gloves. I wash my hands and I am okay touching raw fish. So I'm just basically massaging the oil on the fish. Then once we have that done, we can go over and drizzle our fish with our rub. And same thing, we're gonna use our hands to spread the rub around. And the rub is included in the recipe as well, on the link below. Now we can use our hands. And one of the ingredients is a chile ancho. That's what makes it dark. And once you cook it, you'll see how it gets a little bit blackened. Not burned, just enough black or dark. I'm just making sure that my fish is well seasoned. And I'm rubbing front and back. And if you feel that your fish needs a little bit more rub, go ahead and put a little bit more. I am. Now I'm gonna flip to the back. My rub. And my pan is warming up. Let's go ahead and add some of our oil or cooking spray, whatever you feel comfortable using. Let's see if we can fit two of the fillets in here. Meanwhile, I'm still massaging my fish with the rub. Alright, let me go ahead and wash my hands so we can get started on the second step. Are going ahead and work on our crema. So basically, we're going to use some avocados, sour cream, lime juice, and salt and pepper. If you want a little bit creamy, you can add plain yogurt instead of mayo. Is going to be ready pretty fast. Go ahead and put this here. Because as soon as done cooking, we're going to set it on our plate. Meanwhile, let's finish with our crema. We're adding our avocados. Blend everything. And make it into this creamy yumminess for the tacos. And while I'm doing this, I'm also looking at our fish. Make sure it gets blackened, not burned.
Very fine line.
This is going to happen. That's how you know the fish is ready. You can start falling apart. Put it here. And it's perfect because when you make your tacos, your fish is already cut into pieces. Go ahead and add some more. A little bit of more oil in the middle. Making sure it's spread evenly. Two fish. And again, if you're keeping this healthy, you don't want to add a tablespoon of mayo. You can add some plain yolk. Just to make it a bit more creamier. Perfect. We can add a little bit of salt and pepper for taste. Then to the blender. Easier for me to do it from the sides and get the whole fish and then just flip it that way. This is like two steps in one. Instead of having your sour cream, your plain sour cream, and then your avocado or piece of avocado or guacamole for your tacos, you have the avocado crema. Creamy that is. Just scrape everything out. And then we'll go and check on our fish. We add two more fillets and then we'll get started on our coleslaw. Fish. fiber in. I like the color texture. And I am still keeping an eye on our fish. We're just cutting them into small pieces. They're going to be in our slaw that's going in our fish. So you don't want them too big. Nice little cubes. Cucumber, purple cabbage, some cilantro or parsley, purple onion, and some light inject lime juice, salt and pepper. More cilantro, but I feel that the parsley goes really well with the pineapple and the mango, so just a tiny bit. This is probably 1/4 of the bunch of the parsley, not even the whole thing. Now I'm just chopping this super small, just for flavor. I love how parsley smells. Let me go check on the fish. Bit of parsley, and we're using both parsley and cilantro. Okay. Parsley. We have some cut pineapple already, but let me go ahead and cut some more. Now that I cut the top and the bottom, I'm able to cut it down and it won't roll anywhere. And I just go around and take the sides off. And then I am bending or guiding my knife to cut the skin off. And those little circles.
Smells so good.
Feel bad throwing away all this pineapple. It'll be compost. Okay, take off this part. I want some circles. It's probably time to take out the fish. Pineapple. again, we're gonna cut small chunks. And we do not eat the center of the pineapple. And this is for our slaw. The fresh pineapple wasn't as sweet or as juicy. You never know. So I'm doing a combination of both.
But if they only had canned pineapple, could they use those?
Oh yes, definitely.
Oh, awesome.
You can even get the rings and go ahead and cut them smaller so they can, you know, go in your slaw. Okay, so this one is a little bit more juicy. I am still gonna add, and this is the crushed pineapple. Just wanna make sure it has the pineapple flavor.
The pineapple remix by Carolina.
Parsley's in here already.
Mm, this looks so good.
It's gonna be sweet, it's gonna be tangy, it's gonna be crunchy, it's gonna be fresh. Cucumber. Oh, they're falling apart. Look at all these beautiful colors. I'm excited and ready to mix. And our cilantro. And onion. Not a lot of people don't like onion. That's a slaw right there.
Beautiful.
Right, a little bit of lime juice. Go ahead and add two since these are, it's a lot of slaw. Use a fresh or just the juice. I know they sell bottles of lime juice already. It's not the same, but use what you have. Ooh, this is kind of dry. I'm struggling to get some juice out of here.
There you go.
balsamic's help. Salt and pepper. And we'll mix again. Everything together. Yummy. Assemble our tacos, but for that we need to heat up our tortillas. So we're going to heat them up in the microwave. Have our fish ready, our avocado crema, and our pineapple coleslaw. Now we're waiting on the tortillas to be warm, and then we're gonna make our tacos. Ready to eat. So this is the healthy version of fish tacos. We didn't make the Baja version because those are not that healthy. So this is just a simple recipe. Just make sure you have your rub and pan sear your fish. Fish is cooked pretty fast. Alright. And I know right now with Lent, some people are not eating meat. So, fish it is. Fish recipe. Fish. And basically, you're just gonna break it apart and make your tacos. Come over here. Slaw. You can add more if you like, more fish. But as long as you have like the bottom filled with your fish, you should be good. Another crema. And this is not spicy at all, so if you want hot sauce, it's going to have to be separate. And there you have it, your fish, blackened tilapia fish tacos with pineapple cucumber slaw. Thank you so much for joining us today. Next week, we will be making a Caesar chicken pasta salad. Keeping it healthy here. So join us next time, April 6th. Bye, see you then.